to make it look like actual lock formation. Now, in just a moment, they're going to be turning on the rain effect for us to show you how we can recreate the weather here on our back lot. And then to create a rain effect here in the movie making business, we put very large sensors located overhead outside of the camera's range. When turned on, they've been running a circular decision to make it look like rain is falling, and wind is actually blowing through the rain. Now, this is the part where you will get a little wet, so please bear with us. The big pictures are just a perfect example of a large-scale bombing, which as well as the Empire State Building and Chrysler Buildings. And the Empire State Building and Chrysler Buildings are actually painted glass, done with a little bit of movie magic in one's force perspective. So that makes things look a lot larger and a lot further away than they really are. The actual Empire State Building in New York City is well over 100 stories tall. And ours on our backlot is just a little bit over 4 and only 2 inches thick. And if your movie does not take place in New York City, both the Empire State Building and Chrysler Buildings can't be repeated with the Ukraine Roger Rabbit. You know, they're making a sequel to the movie Ukraine Roger Rabbit that will be released sometime. There are times that they can make our streets look a little bit too real. Now, last spring, when we had one of our production crews come back here to film a commercial, and they threw down $5,000.
Action! From where you're standing, you can see that the magic of movie making does have more to do with illusions than reality. This scene right here in Bette's apartment was filmed in the room you're standing in. But the outside scenes were shot in our own New York street at the back lot here at our studio, not in New York City.
I want New York! New York!
When Bette climbed outside of that window, it was actually a stunt double, Carol Nielsen wearing a matching wig and costume. But back inside, we did need to get some close-ups of Bette, so we recreated the entire apartment inside of a soundstage. Oh, watch out, Bette, you're about to have a death-defying drop to a foam mattress about 2 feet down. Okay, now, the stunt double is outside, though, and she really was hanging for dear life. And of course, she was wearing a safety harness. We hung back in front of this blue screen so that we could superimpose any background behind her that we want. In this case, it was New York City, but if we wanted to, we could send her off to Paris faster than the Concorde. And in this scene right here, the banner fall scene, it was a series of shots. Of course, some of the shots had Bette in them. The more dangerous ones had Carol.
Action!
Before this next complicated scene was filmed, the director, Gary Marshall, made sure that everybody knew the plan. Then it was time for one of the wildest rides ever down the sidewalks of New York. That shopping cart right there was controlled by a track, and some things just need the human touch.
Perfect!
The subway stair sequence began shooting outside on the New York street. But once she started heading down those stairs right there, they switched locations to inside of a soundstage where they had the rest of the stairs built. Those were two separate locations, and when the film was put together, it looked like one. Then it was time for a flight over the turnstile. That effect was done with a compressed air catapult. And when her shoes hit the ground, they might have fallen apart, but they were not cheap. Those heels are just made of wax. A fearsome subway train? Well, it's not what it appeared to be either. But at least our crew made sure to ride on time. The final film you just watched was 2.5 minutes long, but it took our crew of nearly 100 people 5 days to shoot that. That's the reality. Now, we thought the illusions were worth it, but we're now moving on to the next stop.
Here's the scene. The cross of a hot bill. Mary's little brother is hungry, and she doesn't have the money to pay the rent. Okay, Dan. Go get the money to save the ranch and feed the baby. What a fine dog. What's that?
A rock.
Okay, Wolfie. Tell her that you're prepared to share everything with her. Yes, everything. Can good triumph over evil? Can virtue save an innocent child? Good. Now, Mary, fall to your knees and plead.
Cry, Mary, cry.
Sock it to him, Dan.
This is a good moment. I'm blessed. Okay, next scene.
It's our 1921 talkie. Remember, machismo. Make the Zuntigilating tango.
Ooh.
This Argentinian amour will drive the theatergoers wild. Romancer, you are Romeo, and Juliet, alias and Melisande.
War!
You are a good governor!
Boy, just adorable! Steal my big face! Whoa!
You are a Latin lover!
Just like Don Juan. Oi!
Okay, let's move on.
Now, it's 1927, and this is the big desert scene. Rudolph, enter into position and show them your profile. Good. Now, look at the pyramids. She's completely under your control and in your spell. Caught in the magic of love, you're a love slave.
She's under your power.
Now the whole harem is unable to resist you. Now the moment of truth has arrived. She definitely wants a date. So it's time to whisper away to your oasis of romance and your pup tent. That's it. Another magnificent Nickelodeon film is completed. Congratulations!
I was too painless!
Films were good! And then they added some sound. Actors talked, and comics kidded around. Talkies gave us a new kind of show. And they danced and sang about dough!
One man to see. Oh! necessary visas prior to leaving the spaceport. Passengers requiring assistance should visit the nearest information kiosk. Thank you.
Star Tours is now offering convenient daily departures to the exciting moon of Enlightenment visit that you and your family will remember forever. Just ask for the Endor Express, available only from Star Tours. NASA flights need every few minutes, so don't delay. Visit Endor today.
This is inside. This is skinny suit. I don't move.
So everybody's got to move, and nobody moves down the street. There's Grandma. Hi, Grandma. Hello. Turn around. Oh, there you go. Hello. There's Joe.
Joshua, we heard.
There's Richie. To Richie's man, he didn't get insurance.
Come on, Richie, you go.
Thank you.
Brian.
Wherever you dwell, give us a hint by ringing the bell.
Already, don't we? We just started.
Chicken, I can sell it by the pound. My sandwich.
Which one's the daddy?
Thank you.
Yeah. cards.
Christmas 1990. What a mess it is. There's Sue. There's Rich. John's hidden in there. There's his head. There's John.
Oh, no.
Poor lassie, she